All right, so question for you. Have you ever bought an AMD processor? Me neither, but there's a start for everything. Today, I've received this, the AMD Threadripper 1950X, and I cannot stress how special that is. I need to explain something. The CPU market is divided in two different segments. One is a mainstream everyday computer market, going from the computer task to your high-end gamer's rig. And this market has been predominantly dominated by Intel processors, your i3, i5, i7 for the past 20 years or so. The second market is a higher-end top-tier processing machine kind of market. Your 3D rendering, your 3D animation, your video editing kind of computers, the so-called X99, X299 based chipset CPU / motherboard kind of computer machines that we're used to. And those are much more expensive. And the processors are much more complex. They have more cores, more cache memory, more PCI lanes, etc., etc., etc. And as a matter of fact, Intel is also very dominant on that market with this Haswell, Broadwell, and now the new X-series type of CPUs. And that is all well. That is all well until AMD released the Ryzen a couple months ago. And that disrupted absolutely everything. Simply because the Ryzen processors can do better at a cheaper cost than any of the i3, i5, and i7 CPUs can on the mainstream market. But that was not enough. AMD also wanted the top-tier CPU market and came up with a Threadripper. And boy, did they get it right. The specs of the Threadripper 1950X are just stunning. You're talking about 16 physical cores, 32 threaded, 3.4 GHz base clock, turbo to 4.0. It's an unlocked processor, so you can do plenty of overclocking on it. You have up to 64 third generation PCIe lane right in there. For the ones who don't know what that means, you can run 3 video cards, SLI or Crossfire, individually running at 16 full bus speed. That would be my first time, and that will be my first time, because you can be sure I'm gonna try it. You have 40 megabytes of L2 and L3 cache memory. And that's just the start. So how did they do it? This one died. This one died on me out of excitement. So basically, AMD came up with something they called Infinity Fabric. Basically, that means that they took two Ryzen processors and glued them together. And the Infinity Fabric makes those cores act as one single processor. And there's no limit to it. You can put 2 CPU, 4 CPU die, 8 CPU die. I mean, it's just up to infinity. I mean, I'm not making this up. Look at the size of that thing. See that? Compared to a normal processor. You see this? I don't know if you see it. I'll show you in the unboxing in more detail. If not, you can go on my website, laurentschoice.com, nice plug right there, and you have a more detailed walkthrough of the unboxing and the different dimensions. But the point is, yes, there are more than one processor in there. You have at least 2 of those connected through the Infinity Fabric. Let me put this back. All right, so I would feel bad that you don't go through, that we don't do an unboxing in this particular case, because there is no less than 5 unboxing layers until you get to the CPU. It's a little bit ridiculous. So, unboxing. Look at this. It's a massive, beautiful box. All right, first we have to rip the seal apart. Be nice, you might want to keep this aside if you want to resell it. Then we're gonna remove the foam encapsulation of the box. That's the second layer. It's quite big. All right, so here we have a little paper pocket with manual guarantee and the stickers. Cool looking stickers, I gotta say. All right, behind this we have a Torx screw. And what this tool will allow us to do is to lock in and lock out the processor into its TR4 socket. It's a massive 4094 pin socket, which will support this processor. And what we have here is very important. This is our water cooling head adapter. So the cooler adapter will only fit Aztec made coolers from the likes of NZXT and Corsair. So be careful about that. So we are going to unlock the power. Simply turn it counterclockwise and pull here. Now we have the processor. We still have to remove the metallic bracket to hold it all together. And then by pressuring each side of the plastic cover, we should be able to remove it easily. There it is, that's the processor. What's also to be noted that this is the first time AMD is going away from the PGA to the LGA architecture, meaning that the pins are no longer on the processor, but on the motherboard, just like Intel has been doing for some time now. On the back of the Threadripper, we can distinctly see the two different and individual processors who's been connected here through the Infinity Fabric. It's massive. It has a width of 5.5 centimeter and a length of almost 7 centimeters, so it's a mastodon. And here we can see a better comparison of size between our normal, say, LGA 1151 processor and the TR4. Now, the last part I want to cover is its price. You can buy the Threadripper 1950X for $999 US, or $4,000. And to give you a better idea of what that means, to have the equivalent on the Intel side, you'd have to get an i9-7960X. And that is the first processors who come with a 16 physical core and 32 threaded. And that processor will run you $1,699, so basically $700 more. And still, you can be quite secure, you can be certain that the Threadripper 1950X will outperform the i9-7960X simply because we have 600 MHz more on the base clock, 2.8 versus 3.4 GHz. For the 1950X, we have 32 MB of L3 cache, and for the i9-7960X, oh my god, such names, you have only 22 MB of L3 cache, and that makes a world of difference when it comes to raw computing. That will give you a better appreciation of what you're getting for the price you're paying. So that's it. So I just wanted to give you a quick peek on what I've received. And the next thing I'm looking for is a motherboard, which is not available right now. So we're gonna have to wait a few days. In the meantime, I am sending this to a few of my friends for their own review, so you'll probably see this processor going around YouTube. Zutfu, please take care of the thing, be very careful with it, and send it back to me next week. Thank you.